flowers all gathered in old Bethel town in the April of 19 and odd. For the Edwin and Maud was to slide down the ways a Bethel-built schooner new wrought. They slipped her in sideways, the creek was so small, and there she wrote neat and complete. Edwin and Maud, a Chesapeake ram, star of the Chesapeake fleet. Ring out the victory chimes, it's the Edwin and Maud underway. 100 years of pulling Chesapeake Bay. She carried the lumber from Caroline's Capes, all the pine from the Maryland shore, laden with cargo from Chesapeake Bay to Virginia, New Jersey, New York. For 54 years she worked hard on the bay, till battered and busted and beat. Edwin and Maud was the last of the rams, last of the Chesapeake fleet. Ring out the victory chimes, it's the Chesapeake Bay. Now most of your bay boats get run up the marsh, are stripped down from keelson to mast. But the last of the Chesapeake rams headed north, a Bethel-built boat built to last. And 50 years later she's still under sail, carries passengers up the down east. And people call her the Victory Chimes, star of the Windjammer fleet. Ring out the Victory Chimes, it's the Edwin. There aren't many boats being built anymore on the banks of the Chesapeake Bay. A few fancy yachts or a work boat or two are all that you'll see on the waves. But Chesapeake shipwrights can still lay a claim to the finest fleets ever afloat. And the Victory Chimes are the Edwin and Maud. She's still one hell of a boat. Ring out the Victory Chimes, it's the Edwin and Maud underway. 100 years of pulling her time from Maine to the Chesapeake Bay. Victory Chimes.